Hello everyone. So today I would like to make a short video about this wireless service called H2O Wireless. This is a pay-as-you-go 4G LTE service. They also have plans, but I wanted to show how you would configure your Android phone to get 4G LTE connection. This is for people who mostly use Wi-Fi, and you know, on occasions when you don't have Wi-Fi and you want full 4G LTE data speed, you can you know, save money by not signing for an expensive plan, but you can use their pay-as-you-go service. So let me just show you briefly the options they have. So in the plan, if you go to pay-as-you-go, the good thing about it is you can like buy $10, and the $10 you will last for 90 days, and their rates are very reasonable, 5 cents per minute for a text or a call, and the data is 10 cents per megabyte. So this really works for me. Now the purpose of making this video was to show how to configure your phone so that you get the full 4G LTE. So what I experienced was, once I got their SIM card and I put it in my phone, it did not automatically configure my phone correctly. So I was not getting the 4G LTE. In fact, I was not getting any data. And I had to do some Google search, and I finally figured out how to do it, and I would like to share that with you guys. So what you need to do is that you go to your settings. And in your settings, if you go to more, you will see cellular network. You go there, and in that you will see this access point names. Access point names. So you click on that. So you will see something like this. So your SIM card will automatically create an access point network for you. So you will see something called ATT, which is actually the AT&T phone. But the but once you click on it, you will see these values here. They are not configured properly. So the thing that was missing for me was this APN. The APN value was phone in lowercase letter, which was wrong. And I had to basically fix it and enter this value. It's all uppercase, PRODATA. So that's what you need to enter here. The rest of the values, hopefully your SIM card should configure your phone correctly, but for help, I will you know, show my setup, and you can pause the video and confirm that your phone also has the same values. So let me just scroll up. The important thing here is the MMSC, which should be pointing to this mmsc.mobile.atent.net. And your MMC proxy should be proxy.mobile.atnt.net. MMS port should be 80, MCC should be 310, and MNC should be 410. So, and then just make sure that all the other values which you see here, I'm not going to read all of them, but you can pause the video and confirm in your phone you have all this. So once you get all this, go back. And one more thing, if this is not selected, then make sure that it, you know, you select it. And once you have done that, then if you go to your phone and switch off the wireless, I mean switch off your Wi-Fi, switch on the cellular data, then you will see 4G as you are seeing here. And I'm getting very good connection speed now. Now they will charge you 10... for every megabyte, they will charge you 10 cents. So obviously this is not something for, you know, a lot of use, but this is for emergency. Especially if you're like me, who is always on Wi-Fi, this is not a bad option. So I hope this helps. If your phone is still not working, and if your user provider, if your service provider is H2O Wireless, then you can leave a comment, or if you have any question, leave a comment and I will try to help you. Hope this helps. Bye guys.